Hello everyone, PhoenixFellow here, and welcome back to another Let's Play Let's Talk. This one's going to be a little bit controversial. It's going to be... I don't really touch on... Whoa! I have no clue what happened there. I don't really touch on these controversial topics, simply because I don't like, you know, how it becomes. But this one really has me fired up. This one, this one gets under my skin. And if you guys watched the video earlier in the week, I talked about how I was going to talk about these idiots sitting down during the national anthem. Now, I want to get one thing straight. I'm not upset that they're protesting. I'm more upset about what they're protesting, if that makes any sense. We live in America where you have the freedom of speech. You can protest what you want. That's the beautiful thing about our country. Men and women have gone off and fought in the wars to protect that freedom. And they have every right to protest. Just, it's retarded that these are the people getting the attention for the protest. So, if you guys are, you know, living under a rock, because it's been all over the news, San Francisco 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick, I just sound like an ESPN sportscaster there, he decided to sit down during the national anthem, and it raised all kinds of hoopla. People are going nuts about it, and, now, you know, there's a bunch of other NFL stars jumping on the bandwagon and trying to get the same amount of attention, I guess. First, let me just say that I really think that Kaepernick only did it to shine a light on him because his career is really in a crapper right now. So I really think that it was some sort of attention grabber for him. Or he's just really, really dumb. I don't know. It could go either way. Now, let's give a little information about Colin Kaepernick. Colin Kaepernick is a biracial NFL superstar. He got famous. Well, he's actually a multi-sport superstar. He actually was drafted to play in the Major League Baseball, and he wanted to focus on football more. His passion was football. He exploded out of nowhere his rookie year. He was just phenomenal. Here lately, not so much. Not so much. But he is half white, half black. His birth father is black. His birth mother is white. His birth father left his mother before he was ever born. And his birth mother felt that she could not properly take care of him. So she wanted to find a family that could give her son things that she could not. And she chose the Kaepernick family. Oh, I'm sorry. I was doing good. Hold on. Let me get a drink of tea. La 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 la. I've been doing good, and then, you know, here I am hacking along again. So the Kaepernick family adopted Colin at an early age. I don't know exactly what age. I didn't go that much into the guy's history. I just wanted to know a little bit more about him before I touched on the subject. And if you look at pictures of these people's houses and stuff, he never wanted for anything growing up. He never felt the pain and the want of something, you know, like a child born in, let's say, inner city Baltimore, Detroit, stuff like that. He never went through that. Never once in his life. Yes, his birth parents did give him up. His birth father did walk out on him, and that could be argued. You know, he's dealt with those type problems, but the fact being, he never wanted for anything in his life. He was raised by an all-white family that took real good care of Mr. Colin Kaepernick. So Colin Kaepernick decided that he was going to protest the oppression of black people in America by sitting down during the national anthem. Okay, you know, I can listen to you. I can, you know, you got my attention. But why are you getting the attention for it? You know, why are you taking the attention off those who are really going, you know, struggling in this world? You know, the black community that is struggling. Why are you putting the spotlight on yourself? Have you donated to Black Lives Matter? No, you haven't given a penny to Black Lives Matter? Well, don't you think, you know, funding their organization would, you know, better help them get the spotlight they need on themselves? No, you want the okay. Okay, well, now I can't stand behind you. You're a half white, half black child that was adopted by a rich white family. You've never been oppressed in your life. Sit down. Well, actually, stand up, put your hand over your heart, and shut up. That's my firm belief. You know, he is the worst role model for people to follow. Okay? He's never had to deal with any of it. And by him doing it, yes, he's being talked about. They're talking more about Colin Kaepernick than they are the oppression of African-American people, which I don't really consider. I'm using their words, okay? I'm trying to stay middle ground here. But he is getting more attention of him sitting down than why he's sitting down, if that makes any sense at all. So it's bothersome, it really is, that someone like that who, you know, let me tell you a story of, I'm going off on a tangent here, and I'm doing this because I'm a Ravens fan, and I know a little bit more about my Ravens players than I do any other players on any other team. But Justin Forsett is a running back for the Baltimore Ravens. He's been with the Ravens, I think, 2-3 years now. And he has gone out of his way to help communities in the past. You know, he played in Seattle, I believe, for a little while. He helped communities over there. He's helped communities in Baltimore. He's even this year when they played New Orleans in preseason, he stayed behind in New Orleans, donated his time and his money to those affected by the flood down there. He put his money where his mouth was. He felt strongly about the case or the cause. He donated it, not just money. Like, he didn't just throw money at him. He stayed behind in New Orleans after the rest of the team had left and volunteered to help spend time with families and children and all that. That is a role model. That is someone you want your kids looking up to. Not Colin Kaepernick, the guy who is protesting black oppression when he never went through it at all. He never struggled at all growing up. He's never once felt that pain. He never once. Why would you rather glorify him than someone like Justin Forsett? And again, there are plenty of other role models within the NFL. Justin Forsett is just one of my favorites. he does a lot to help out the community. And Ray Lewis was another one. Ray Lewis is a questionable character. You know, he, you know, suspected of murder and all that. But he did a lot for Baltimore. And still, to this day, does a lot for Baltimore that people don't realize. I mean, when the Baltimore riots were going on, he was... Him and the rest of the Ravens were out there, you know, helping rebuild, fix stuff. And he was... When it was all going down, he was on his Facebook, his personal Facebook, begging and pleading the rioters to stop, saying, you know, this isn't how we do it here in Baltimore. This is not what we're about. You know, those are role models. You know, yes, he had a questionable past, but now he's matured and all this. He's more of a role model than Colin Kaepernick. You know, Colin Kaepernick just kind of sits back and, you know, lets it play out. He doesn't care either way what goes on. Sorry, I had to get a drink before I start coughing again. He could care less. He doesn't care. You know, he's primarily white. He's raised by white family, and he is 50% white. He doesn't care. Regardless of what happens to, you know, those who are considered oppressed, he's going to go home to his mansion, kick his feet up, and cash his million-dollar checks, which he hands none over to those struggling, okay? Why is that a role model? Why? And it's gotten even worse now that more people are joining in. There was a football player I used to have respect for, Arian Foster. I thought he was a good guy. He showed signs of that being that Justin Forsett type. But he took a knee on September 11th, of all days. of all days, September 11th. He, you know, these guys chose to stand with the movement. Well, sit, kneel, whatever. They chose 9/11 of all days, which is just disgusting beyond what Kaepernick does. But yeah, he was someone I liked as a football player. I thought he was a good guy. When Colin Kaepernick first sat down, Arian Foster came out and said he wouldn't do that. Now his story is changing. Okay, a reporter called him out on it, and Arian Foster's response was, "I never said that. I never said that. What I said was I wouldn't have started it." Practically saying you wouldn't do it. Now you see the attention that Colin Kaepernick's getting. You went in on the action. That's pretty much what it is. That's what all these guys are. They are too cowardice to stand up, you know, make things happen on their own. They're going to wait for someone else to do it and take the heat. Now they're going to turn it into a big thing. But as disgusting as it is to not honor the flag on September 11th of all days, it's just disheartening that the NFL has not chosen to fine these people, but instead fine the players wearing 9/11 memorial cleats on 9/11. This is a story. And Roger Goodell makes me sick, okay? The fact that he actually enforced this is sickening. It makes me not want to watch the NFL anymore, even though it is my favorite sport to watch. Some football players wanted to wear special cleats on 9/11 that had, you know, always remember, it was very patriotic and everything. And an NFL announced that they would fine any player wearing them for not being up to the uniform code. I mean, they make special exceptions for anything else. Why are they so anti-American? You know, why is it? And everybody's like, oh, it's not anti-American, it's just uniform code. No. 9/11 is a sacred day now for the terrible events that happened on September 11, 2001, 9/11 will always hold a place in all of our, if we were alive at that time, will always hold a place in our minds. The terror, the gut-wrenching images that you've seen on that TV screen that day, or if you were in New York yourself, that you watched play out firsthand. That day should never be used to garner yourself attention. It should never be used the way that these football players decided to use 9/11. It's sickening. I know some people are going to get peeved by this, but you are disrespecting every single person that died on 9/11. Every single firefighter, that's 343 firefighters that died on 9/11. Rushing into those buildings to save any person they could. And not only firefighters, police, you know, not even one of these 343, sorry, I got my numbers jumbled, that died. The countless of others that died and got serious illnesses from dealing with that crap down at Ground Zero. You're disrespecting their memory. You're disrespecting the armed forces that rushed to Afghanistan to rain holy hell on those that attacked us. So many people forget what it was like that day. I certainly never will forget. I was in sixth grade at the time. Our school had not started yet because they were building a new building, and it was way behind schedule. And I remember when we were out that morning and heard it on the radio. Me being the history buff I am, knew this was the day that it was going to be a day that just lives on. And I sat and watched literally all day until I fell asleep that night what played out on my TV. I will never forget that day. I will never, ever think about using 9/11 to garner attention. That's why when I did my 9/11 parade video, I didn't do it for attention. I didn't speak in the video. I didn't say like or subscribe in the video. None of that. My intro played, because my intro plays at the beginning of all my videos. It's kind of a copyright, so people can't take the video and use it for their own means. It's not what the day is supposed to be about. The day is supposed to be about remembering a dark day in our history where thousands of people died because of pure hatred. And now you're doing the same by spreading hatred to those you see, you know, you're spewing hate when you say, I'm not going to respect a flag that oppresses my people. That's hate speech. You're being anti-American right now, you know, especially on 9/11. Sorry, I'm going off on a whole tangent, but I honestly believe that we need, you know, anyone that complains about how bad they have it in America, we should pay for them to go live in another country for just a month. You know, send them to Africa, send them to Europe, send them to Russia, send them to the Middle East. Let's send them all over there, spend 1 month living in another country to see if they get it any better. You won't. You know, Colin Kaepernick and all these other football players, they're not going to go off to another country to play football. Matter of fact, I think the only other country that has American football is Canada. And up in Canada, I'm sorry, I was doing so good. up in Canada, they don't make millions of dollars. Colin Kaepernick would not go to Canada and play in the CFL and make millions of dollars. The average football player in the CFL makes $80,000 a year. A huge difference compared to the American counterpart. So, you know, Colin Kaepernick would never go to Canada to play football. He's got it made. He's got it made here in America. You know, the ones crying out oppression. These football players are jokes. Guys, don't consider them role models. Don't want to follow in their footsteps. Because they're millionaires for working, what, 6 months out of a year? Playing 2-3 hours a week? The big game, you know, they got practice throughout the whole week, but the majority of their time is spent on a field for a couple hours on Sunday, Monday, or Thursday. Don't idolize them. Idolize the ones that are out there trying to make a difference, that is putting their time, effort, and money into a cause to do something good, make positive change, not create more hate. So that's going to do it for today, guys. Again, it was kind of a controversial topic. I don't really do much of those simply because I don't like controversy. But it's disheartening what, you know, America's coming to, where football players, role models, are seeking attention off someone else's struggle. It's just disheartening. But if you guys liked the video, be sure to leave a like down below. If you guys want to see more Let's Plays, Let's Talks, be sure to click subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.